Hello, my name is Arnaud Delorme, and this is a presentation about using the Brain Imaging Data Structure EGLab plugin to import and export BITS data. If you want to know what BITS is, there is another presentation on this topic, and I put the link in the description. I advise that you watch this other presentation first, especially the part concerning the BITS example file. In this presentation, first I will show you how to import BITS data into EGLab and then how to export raw data to BITS. So this assumes you have installed EGLab. Of course, I put a link to download EGLab in the description. After starting EGLab, we need to install or update the BITS EGLab plugin. For this, you go to the EGLab plugin manager, which is this menu item. Then you find the BITS plugin. You can also search for BITS using the search feature in the top right corner. Once you found it, you simply install it, and this will add a BITS submenu item to the EGLab file menu, as we'll see in a second. So let's start with importing some BITS data. Importing is simpler than exporting. Also, importing BITS data will allow us to quickly review the BITS format. After we import this data, I will show you how to export raw data to BITS on a simplified example. So this is the dataset we're going to use. It's available for public download on the OpenNeuro website. Also, I put a link in the description below. You can look at the files. You can also download the whole dataset as a zip archive. NEMAR is an extension of OpenNeuro for the EEG and MEG community, which we are building in collaboration with OpenNeuro. In this experiment, participants are performing an oddball task where they press a button whenever they hear an oddball sound. I'm going to play a sample audio recording in a second. So you have standard stimuli, which are frequent, and these will be the first three. Then occasionally you have oddball and noise stimuli. The task of the participants is to press a button when they hear the oddball. The noise stimuli are just distractor in which you're not supposed to respond. Let's hear it. So in this case, we have 70% of standard, 15% of oddball, and 15% of noise stimuli.
Mr. Delorme?
Yes, me from the past.
This experiment makes no sense to me. How can you study cognition with beeps and boops? Don't you want to put people in virtual reality or something a little bit more challenging?
Well, historically, these are the type of tasks we've been using in psychophysics. It has its value, but I agree that these days we can also do experiments with richer environments. Anyway, let's pursue. Once we've downloaded this dataset, let's review what it contains. The BITS video, link in the description, goes further into detail into this topic, so I'm going to go fast here. The Brain Imaging Data Structure, or BITS, is a way to name your folders and your files for an experiment, as well as adding a collection of formatted text files, so it follows the BITS specification. The advantage of using BITS is that EGLab can automatically import BITS folder structure as an EGLab study, which means as a group of data sets from multiple subjects that is readily available for group processing. EGLab can also import additional event and channel information contained in BITS file that is often not available in the raw EEG data file. So here's the folder we've just downloaded. And we're gonna look at some files. First, the participant.tsv, so it contains gender, age column, and one row per participant. Then we have the subject folder and EG subfolder. So here we have three runs, so three sets of files. We're just going to look at one of the set, for example, the channel file, which contains channel labels and channel types. And then we have the electrode file, which contains the coordinates. If you want to know why they're different files, you can look at the other BITS video, the first of this series. Then we have the event file, which contains a collection of event, one per row, and here we have many. And then different columns, value, trial type, and then onset, which is the beginning of the event. And so now we're going to just import this dataset. So we select the menu, import, and here we're going to select these two checkboxes to overwrite events. And so here, when these checkboxes are selected, EEGLab will import the raw EEG data files, but will overwrite the event and channel information with the information stored in the bits files. If the dataset you downloaded is well formatted in bits, it will rename events, add channel locations and channel types, etc. You may select the bits field you want to import to define EEGLab data types. The two choices are bits event values and bits event trial types. So you need to look at the bits event file, as we've done previously, to see which one makes the most sense for you based on the analysis you want to do with the data. So here we map EEGLab event types to the value bits field. Then we press OK, and now the bits data is imported as an EEGLab study. There is another video on how to process this data in EEGLab, and I put a link in the description. So we've imported some bits data. Now let's try to export some data. So I have this raw data that I've prepared. It is the same data as the one we've imported, but here I only have 2 subjects instead of 13. I put a link to the raw data file on top of this slide and also in the description. First, we're going to import the raw data. I will import 6 data files from 2 subjects with 3 runs per subject. Both EEGLab and BIDS support runs and sessions per subject. Basically, a run is when you have a block in an experiment and when the data from each block is stored in a separate file. Sessions are used when the data is collected on different days or when there's a break that involves removing the EEG cap. There is no hard definition. This is what I like to use, and I think most of the EEG researchers would agree. For runs in EEG, we're not removing the cap, but for EEG sessions, we're removing the cap. So let's import these 6 data files. These are BDF files, which is a specific research amplifier and data collection program. And I'm selecting them here and then simply agreeing to import them with the default option. I'm also agreeing to save the file on disk as EEGLab datasets. Note that here I can import several files at once, but in older version of EEGLab, you have to import them one by one. Now we're going to create a study with these files. So we enter subject and run information and press OK when we're done. And now we have the raw data files imported in EEGLab. Before we enter bits information, let's assign locations to our electrodes. So in the raw data files, channel locations are often not available. In EEGLab, we can simply use the channel location menu item, and based on the channel labels, it will automatically use template locations. There are several choices for the templates. Here I'm using the template BEM channel location, which are usually preferred compared to the default spherical channel coordinates. We'll simply change the default in the near future. Channel locations will be exported along with the bits dataset. So researcher will import your data will already have electrode locations for your datasets. Now moving on to bids. Let's first enter task and experiment information. So this is this menu item. So here it's pre-filled, but obviously you would need to fill that information yourself. So we have a dataset name, then a dataset name with no space. Then we have a short description that will be stored in the README file. Then we have the description of the experiment and instructions given to participants. Then we have offers, publication references, if any, and lab information. On the right column, we have amplifier and EEG cap characteristics. Most of the fields on these forms are optional, but obviously it will be harder for other people to use your data if there is missing information. Second, let's enter participant information. So this is this second menu item. So here we have 2 participants and 1 row per subject. I'm going to enter gender and age information. For gender, I can also go in the description table and indicate what F means. If you remember the bits video, the participant information will be stored in the participant.tsv file that contains 1 row per subject. And the column information will be stored in the participant.json file. We can also import a text file or Excel file with additional columns. So here I have a file with additional demographic information. So I press the import button, select the file, and I need to select the participant ID column. And this column is contain the same participant ID as I already have. I can also select column for a predetermined bits column, and I can select column which will be added to the participant file. Then let's look at events. This is the next menu on the list. So here I select the EEGLab event fields for each bits event column. If it is empty, it's fine. So onset corresponds to the latent field of EEGLab, although this field is in sample, so it is converted to second here from the sample field. Then we have bits event duration, usually associated with the EEGLab duration field if it is present. Then we have the bids sample field, which is equivalent to the EEGLab latency field. Then we have trial types, which can be, for example, stimulus or response. Then we have response time, for example, when you have a reaction time to stimulus. Then we have a stim file, which may contain the name of a stimulus file stored in the stimuli bits folder. Finally, we have the value field, which is the value associated with the event. Here, our event can take value 1, 2, 3, 4, and 8, and they are stored in the type field of EEGLab. We're also going to define these events. So we have response corresponding to type 1. We have type 2, which is standard stimuli, which are sounds at 500 Hz for 60 milliseconds. We have type 3, which we can ignore here. This is a glitch, and they're very rare. We have type 4, which is an outball stimuli, which are sounds at 1000 Hz for 60 milliseconds. And we have type 5, which is the white noise for 60 milliseconds. We can add one or more custom fields. Here I'm adding the test fields. And for this custom bits field, I'm selecting the EEGLab field EDF type. And so now we're done entering all that information. Note that the information is stored along with the dataset, so I advise you resave the dataset so when you're done editing bits documentation, and we're ready to export. So we select the export menu in the bits submenu. Here it is asking us where we want to save the exported data, the type of license we want to use, and change the last changes since the last published export. For example, you might have exported the first time and published your data, but some information was missing, so you're not exporting the bits dataset a second time. You can leave that empty. You also have the option to click on buttons to review or edit the task, participant, and event information. Finally, if you have not anonymized your subject ID, for example, if you use subject initial for their idea, which is bad practice but sometimes happens, you can check this box to generate new anonymized ID. So you press OK and your data has been exported. The next step is to check that your data is bits compliant. Since you use the EEGLab plugin to export it, it should always be bits compliant. So there will likely not be any error. However, sometimes there are warnings. So this is the menu to call the bits validator. So it simply asks you for a folder to validate. Once you press OK, it prints a report on the MATLAB command line. In this case, there is a warning message because there is only one offer for a study, and the bits validator judges that this might be an omission. So now we're ready to go to a data repository such as OpenNeuro, log in with your Google account, and upload your bits folder. So it's that simple. Note that it is also possible to use the plugin from the command line. So this is a script to export the raw data that will automatically copy or convert the raw data files, fill up task, participant, and event information. So here I have two slides of an example script. The script allows you to indicate binary raw EEG data files. So here in this first section, and there is one entry per subject. If you have more than one file per subject, you can define a list of files along with the session and run they correspond to. You can also indicate recording notes. Then you have a section for the README file and for the content of the dataset description file. Then you have a section for the task information and a section for participants. For participants, you can define both participants' columns and column descriptions. Then we have event descriptions as well as event column file description. These are special options to rename EG lab event types and define new trial types based on EG lab events types, and these options are not available on the graphic interface. Then we have a section of the code to include. In this case, we're including the function used to present stimuli as well as the current script. Note that exporting the code is not available from the graphic interface because you can simply copy these files to the code folder of the BIDS exported archive. This is the same if you have stimuli, you can create a stimuli folder and copy your stimuli into it. Most of this script is about building a parameter list for the export function. So here at the bottom, we have the export function. So download this script and the associated data, run it, then modify it to prepare your own data. So I hope you will use this plugin. I want to thank you for your attention, and I hope to see you in one of my future videos.